Welcome to lab number 2. To perform load or brake test on DC shunt motor with mechanical load. The picture shows mechanical load arrangement on DC motor. So in this, a flat belt is wound around the pulley and its two ends are attached to two spring balances, S1 and S2. The tension of the belt can be adjusted with the help of hand wheels. Apparatus required for these experiments are: number 1, DC shunt motor of rating 3 HP, 220 volt, 12 ampere, 1500 rpm with brake drum arrangement. So in this, 3 HP means the mechanical output delivered by the motor. To deliver this output, the applied voltage required is 220 volt DC and the current taken by the motor is 12 ampere DC, while the rated revolutions per minute are 1500 rpm. Second, DC voltmeter of range 0 to 300 volt to measure voltage. Number 3, DC ammeter of range 0 to 20 ampere to measure current taken by the motor. Number 4, field rheostat of rating 1000 ohm and 1.2 ampere. So this rheostat is required to insert in field current so that we can control field current, so that phi will be controlled and thereby speed of the motor can be controlled. So the important thing is, while selecting rheostat, the field current should be considered. So the selected motor has field current 0.6 ampere. So 1 ampere or 1.2 ampere rheostat will be sufficient. And the field current of the motor is given on the nameplate of the motor. Number 5, tachometer to measure speed of the motor. And number 6, connecting wire. First figure shows connection diagram for load test on DC shunt motor. So this, the shaft of the motor is connected to the brake drum arrangement. In DC shunt motor, the field winding, which is shown by FFF, is connected in parallel with armature, that is AAA. So AAA is armature winding and FFF is field winding. So we can see that a rheostat to control field current is connected in series with field winding. Applied voltage, which is 220 volt DC, is given to the motor through 3-point starter. So 3-point starter has three terminals, L, F and A, where L is line terminal, F is field terminal and A is armature terminal. To measure voltage, a voltmeter is connected, and to measure current taken by the motor is connected in series. So here we can see that the current measured by the ammeter is total current, that is field current plus armature current. Second picture shows brake drum arrangement for DC shunt motor. Here we can see motor rotates in anti-clockwise direction, so therefore it is supporting spring balance F2 and the opposite force is acting on F1. So the reading taken will be F1 greater than F2. So therefore in formula we should write F1 minus F2. Next point, procedure. The first point is connect the circuit as shown in figure. Number 2, set the field rheostat of motor to 0, that is the rheostat in the field winding should be at minimum position, that is the resistance offered by the rheostat should be 0, so that the rated current will be full flow through the field winding. So in our case the field current is 0.6 ampere. Number 3, remove the load on the motor and start it with the help of starter. So while doing any practical on DC shunt motor, the load on the shaft should be 0 and the starter is used 3-point starter. Therefore the motor, or while starting practical, the motor will be started by using 3-point starter. Fourth point, adjust the field rheostat of the motor to obtain rated speed. And then don't disturb the setting. After starting motor, vary field rheostat such that the motor will run at rated speed. So in our case, the rated speed is 1500 RPM. So after this setting, don't disturb rheostat. Number 5, note the meter readings and speed at this no load condition. Number 6, now increase the mechanical load in steps by tightening the belt and note all the readings again. So after first reading, increase the load step by step by tightening belt by using hand wheels and note all readings, that is current, voltage, speed, F1 and F2. Number 7, repeat 5 to 6 to cover the range of no load to full load of the motor. So increase the load on the motor such that the rated current will be shown by ammeter, that is 12 ampere. So we started from no load on the shaft to the maximum load, that is when ammeter will show 12 ampere reading. And last is calculate torque and efficiency of the motor. Next point, precautions while doing this experiment. Number 1, all connections should be perfectly tight and no loose wire should lie on the work table. So this is common practice for any electrical experiment. Number 2, before switching on the DC supply, ensure that the starter's moving arm, that is handle, is at its maximum resistance position. So for 3-point starter, we have diagram such that, so this is maximum resistance position. So before starting practical, this arm should be at this position. After switching on DC supply, this arm will be moved like this in slow manner. Next, number 3, do not switch on or operate the DC shunt motor with heavy load on the shaft. So in opposite to DC series motor, the DC shunt motor should not be started at heavy load. Number 4, before switching on the DC supply, ensure some water inside the drum for cooling purpose. So like DC series motor, we should have some water in the drum for cooling purpose, because due to friction between drum and belt, large heat will be generated and it may burn belt. So therefore some cooling water is required. So for this, keep one water bottle. Number 5, do not switch on the supply until and unless the connections are checked by the supervisor. So this is also common practice for any electrical experiment. Number 6, avoid error due to parallax while reading the meters. So what is parallax error? So it is an error in reading an instrument due to the eye of the observer and pointer are not in a line perpendicular to the plane of the scale. Number 7, hold the tachometer with both hands steady and in line with the motor shaft so that it reads correctly. Next, observation table. So the readings taken are Vm, that is voltage applied to the motor, Im, current taken by the motor, F1 and F2, that is spring balances, and N, speed of the motor. Here we have to note radius of the brake drum, and this can be measured by two ways. Number 1, by taking radius from the center of the drum up to the surface of the belt, or by taking radius from center of the drum to the surface of the drum, that is RB, plus thickness of the belt, and the summation is radius of the drum. The basic aim of this experiment is to calculate efficiency, and we know that the efficiency formula is output power upon input power. So in this case, output power is mechanical and the input power is electrical. Electrical power can be calculated by using this formula. Electrical power is equals to voltage into current, and the mechanical power, that is output power, can be calculated by using this formula 2πNT/60, where N is speed of the motor and T is the shaft torque. Shaft torque is again calculated by using this equation, that is 9.81 into F1 minus F2 into R, where R is the radius of the drum, F1 and F2, the difference F1 minus F2 is a force is acting on the drum, and 9.81 is the gravitational constant. So F1 and F2 are in kilogram, and the whole is converted into Newton by multiplying 9.81, where R is the radius of the drum in meter. So in our case, it is 0.15 meter. The picture shows actual observation table of load test which is performed on the DC shunt motor. So in this observation table, we have measured applied voltage to the motor, that is 215, which is constant, current taken by the motor. In this, we have two currents. So the first column shows field current and the second column shows armature current taken by the motor. So finally, when we calculate power, that is input power, P equals to V into I, so we have to take summation of IF and IA, so that is total current taken by the motor. So you can see that in this, the field current IF is constant, so therefore this is constant flux motor. And the second column shows that as load increases on the motor, current taken by the armature also increases. The third column is input power, that can be calculated by multiplying voltage and current. Next column is F1 in kilogram, and second is F2 in kilogram. So both can be varied, or only one can be varied, while second will be at constant. Next column is N speed in RPM, that is measured by tachometer. And next, torque, which can be calculated by using formula 9.81 into radius of the drum into F1 minus F2 Newton meter. And the output power, the formula is 2πNT/60. And the finally efficiency, output power upon input power, that is mechanical power upon electrical power. So the first reading taken at no load, that is no load on the shaft. So therefore, there is no reading on the spring balances F1 and F2, so they are blank, and therefore torque is not calculated. The speed is 1498, so it is rated near about 1500 RPM. So after that, the load is increased slightly in step by step. So second reading 215, applied voltage is also constant, and the field current is also constant, and the armature current is somewhat increased, that is 1, and so on. So the efficiency is 35.4. so as we increase load, the current taken by the motor increases, so therefore input power also increases, and the speed of the motor decreases slightly, so there is no drastic change in the speed, and torque also increases, and the output power also increases. But in the efficiency is increases up to 49.60, and again it decreases. The picture shows graph between speed on y-axis and torque on x-axis. So we can see as load on DC shunt motor increases, there is slight decrease in speed of the motor. In DC series motor, as load increases, there is drastic decrease in speed. So this is for series motor and the shunt motor. So we can say that the conclusion, DC shunt motor is constant speed motor. The conclusion of the experiment, with rise in load, the motor current increases and the speed decreases slightly. The efficiency initially increases with the load, reaches to its maximum and then decreases. Some viva questions are there on this experiment. Number one, how do you load the motor in this experiment? Number two, what was the assumption made in calculations? Number three, what is the condition for maximum torque of a DC shunt motor? Number four, why is the starter necessary?